If you like cheap, easy, fast land transformation projects, old field management is for you. Today we're going to talk about how this field has gone through its transformation and what the next steps are in maintaining this quality habitat. All right, guys, you probably have seen on several other videos the same exact site, but now we're at a different stage in the growing season and pretty much the end of growing season year one. So it's a great time to come back and recap what had happened on the site, the transformation, and where we're at now, but most importantly, what we're gonna do in the future to make sure this site stays quality and offers early successional plant communities for the wildlife that I'm intending to promote here on the property. So back in April, this area was completely dominated by fescue, cool season grass. It was terminated using glyphosate during late April. And then following up that, about 3 weeks later into late May, this area was burned. So we removed the dead thatch from the fescue, trying to expose the seed bank and allowing it to express itself. So we removed the competition of the fescue, burned that off late May, and then we went into about a 6 week drought where there was no rain, 100 plus degree heat, but that honestly did not stop the natives from blowing up and still producing quality forage and cover in this unit. So now it is late August, early September, and what we're seeing is a field that is now dominated by ragweed, common ragweed. And a lot of people may not like that, but wildlife love it. So I love it. It's extremely functional in its forage capabilities, from deer consuming it during the growing season, very high in crude protein palatability, talking 26% crude protein and a lot of tissue sampling. But then in addition to that, the seed production for birds, for turkeys, for quail, there are some quail around. So during the winter time frame, we've got woody structure, we've got lots of ragweed production that we could easily potentially see quail hanging out in this unit. But prior to that, when it was just dominated by fescue, never would have seen it. So that's a quick snapshot of how we got here. But most importantly, let's talk about beyond the ragweed, what we're seeing. We're seeing a little bit of grease grass. We're seeing some croton. We're seeing some partridge pre coming back in here. Right now, again, it's dominated because of the height of the ragweed, but there are a lot of other goodies and diversity, some desmodiums through here in this site. A little bit of ironweed, and we had some existing persimmon sprouts. Those got top killed by the fire, so what you're seeing is that sprouting coming back post-fire. So those are on their way. We have a little bit of herbaceous, a little bit of grass communities, and then some woody structure in here as well. You can probably notice I have edge feathered a little bit on the sides of the field too. So as we move forward from here, again, positive response year one, the next follow-up steps, honestly, to sit back and wait a little bit. We need time to allow this plant community to diversify itself, go from year one to two to three. We want to make sure in that time frame that we don't have any noxious plants come back. There was a little spot of Cerisa lespediza that I sprayed prior to doing all the cool season conversion. So we want to make sure that that does not come back. And if so, we're going to spot treat it with a glyphosate application. But largely, we're sitting back for the next two growing seasons. So we basically build back up our thatch load so we can have a prescribed fire come through here. And really that's what we're going to use to maintain this site. So it's a very easy transformation, a very positive response from the plant communities. They're going to continue to diversify themselves, but really maintenance wise, one or two trips through here with a backpack sprayer or UTV sprayer each growing season until we have enough fuel load to burn this. That's it. We're going to let it, you know, do its thing. There'll be nesting opportunities for wild turkeys. There'll probably be some brood rearing, lots of growing season forages, fawning cover. And this is a nice transition from some bedding area right next to me working out to a perennial food source. So with this height structure that we have here, we can experience and anticipate a lot of daylight movement moving through this unit. So I'm really excited, happy with the transformation, the success so far, and even more thrilled that it's easy to maintain from here.